Hi everybody.
Hope everybody had a good day. And I really haven't talked since our grandson was born yesterday morning. The days are starting to run into each other. First my sister being here, Bugs and Rug, and then the next day the labor and then the delivery. And our family is known for not doing things, not, I wouldn't say that the natural way or the normal way, but we just go about things differently. Like, odd things happen and we laugh about it after. But I know my sister Chris has been writing me today saying, what happened? Why wasn't anybody there? Why did the mother cut the cord herself? Well, it started after Bugs and Rod left. Christine, my daughter-in-law, she started to get twinges. She thought maybe she was going to go into labor. She wasn't sure, but I think it was from all the laughter here that kind of shook her up. But on the Sunday she called me and she was having backache like every 20 minutes or something, not regular, and she thought maybe not tense. So I figured no, not really, but just in case I told her, I said, you get out and you get walking, keep walking, because that'll help. If you're in labor, the walking will help. And so they got someone to watch their 2.5-year-old daughter, Jessica, who you've seen on here. And they walked. And I meant for them to walk around the block or something. I don't understand why this all took place, that they didn't just go around the block. No. My son drove his wife up to a place we call Suicide Hill, where you go tobogganing in the winter. And it was almost midnight, and he had her climbing the hill, and the pains got so bad that she laid down in the field, and she thought she was going to have it right there. Well, got her up and headed for the hospital. And they said, yeah, you're in labor, all right, and you're staying here. So time went by, we all went to bed, and got a call from them about 12:30 saying that, yeah, she's staying for sure, and it's going to be quite a while.
Really?
I fell asleep, kept waking up. Fell asleep, kept waking up. I had a feeling it was going to be this weekend because of the full moon. And of course, believing in astrology, the moon was in Aquarius, and the baby's father is an Aquarian. And it all, if you know much about astrology, it's like a family tree, the way that the signs all interconnect. Well, he called us at 5:30 from the hospital to say that she was at 5 centimeters and she had had her epidural and she was just fine, and maybe we should get up and come to the hospital now, because I wanted to get pictures and her mother wanted to be there too. So we got up and I'm getting dressed. Now mind you, he called at 5:30 a.m. and she was 5 centimeters. I'm getting dressed, the phone rings, it's the hospital. And in the meantime, he's taking little Jessica over to our daughter's, his sister's place, where she's going to sleep for the night. So he's not at the hospital, he's finding a place for his daughter. I get a call from the hospital and they said, do you know where Christine's husband is? And I said, well, he's transporting their daughter someplace for the night, and I thought, well, why would the hospital call here? And she said, does he have a cell? And I said, no, he doesn't have a cell phone. Why? And she said, I think you better hurry up. Well, we out the door in the car and banged to the hospital. Well, I guess her husband had walked in just prior to us. And he walked in and there was the baby in the warming table that they put them on after they're born. And he just like, what happened here? Baby was born at 6:10. And he had called me at 5:30 and she was 5 centimeters. She went from 5 to 10 in a half an hour, gave 2 pushes and the baby was out. That's the way to have them. Anyway, we weren't there. The father wasn't there. So the nurse grabbed the camera and said, here, cut the cord, and she took pictures. These types of things happen in our family. It's just, but we don't do anything in the way, an organized manner. We don't. No, can't be. But it's done, and he's beautiful. He's gorgeous. We were over there tonight, and she's home now with the baby, and Jessica's just not too sure about him. She kind of looks at him and, yeah, okay, and when are you going to take him back type of look, but she'll get used to him. She'll be fine because they are also foster parents, so she is used to seeing other little ones and babies in the house too. What was I going to say? I don't know. I am so tired. I'm glad to see my sister's back. She was out the trailer there for a couple of days and missed it too. And we may be going away next week at some point, and we'll be here on and off until Labor Day weekend. We'll be here to stay, hopefully. But I'll be here on and off, and I'll come out and say hi when I can. And I think that was it. There might be more. I wanted to tell my sister, those are called sand fleas. Those things that are itching your feet. They bite your feet. And we used to get them up a dipper wash when we camped there. And there's a special thing you can get at the drugstore. You go to the drugstore and tell them what, you know, that there's sand flea bites and there's something for that. You can rub that on there. It's like a liquid type thing. And I don't know. Between all the laughter with my sister being here and the surprise visit and then the baby, and I'm exhausted. Now I gotta pack to go away. But we might be going, I don't know, Monday or Tuesday next week. I'm not sure. See, and then I'll be back the following week for 3 or 4 days because the 13th, 14th, 15th, the Wiz has shows to do, so we have to be in town anyway. And I'm really rattling on. What's happened to me? I just can't stop talking. I think it's because I'm tired. And anyway, everybody, have a good evening. Enjoy the remains of the day, and I'll talk to you again soon. Okay, bye. I know what it was I forgot to tell you. I just came back to add this, that the hospital was giving all the babies born a Canadian toque because the Winter Olympics this year are being held in Canada, out in BC. Okay, and I'll see if I can get a pick up for that. Okay, bye everybody.